In this video, we're going to be taking a look at long division, which is the standard procedure used for dividing numbers. Now here, divide 84,713 by the number 156 using long division. Well, in this question, our divisor here is a multi-digit number, 156, and our dividend here is also a multi-digit number, 84,713. So I want you to pause the video now and try this example on your own. So again here, the divisor is the multi-digit number 156, and your dividend here is also a multi-digit number 84,713. Now when dividing using multi-digit divisors, it's a little bit more difficult than if your divisor was just a single digit. Now you're going to have to think of the amount of times 156 evenly goes in to the first number in your dividend, which is 8. Well, 156 doesn't go into 8 evenly, so we're going to put a 0 up above the 8. Now 0 times 156 gives me 0, so we put a 0 down below the 8 in the dividend. We subtract these two numbers. Now 8 minus 0 gives me 8, and then the next step in the long division procedure is to bring down the next number in the dividend. Now the next number in the dividend is the 4, so I'm going to put an x right below the 4 just to remind myself that I'm bringing it down. So 156, again, cannot go into 84 evenly, so I'm putting another 0 up above the 4 in the dividend. 0 times 156 gives me 0, and I'm going to subtract those two numbers. So 84 minus 0 gives me 84, and we're now ready to bring down the next number in the dividend. So I'm putting an x under the number 7 and bringing the 7 down. Now we have to think about how many times 156 can evenly go in to 847. Well, 156 can go into 847 a total of 5 times evenly. So I'm going to put a 5 up above the 7 in the dividend. Now we need to multiply the 5 by the 156. So 5 times 156 would give me 780. Now I need to subtract these two numbers. So 7 minus 0 gives me 7. 14 minus 8 gives me 6. 7 minus 7 gives me 0. I'm now ready to bring down the next number in the dividend, which is the 1. Now, how many times can 156 evenly go in to 671? Well, that can go in 4 times evenly. So I'm going to put a 4 up above the 1, and 4 times 156 gives us 624. And we're now ready to subtract those two numbers. So 11 minus 4 gives us 7. 6 minus 2 gives us 4. And I'm now ready to bring down the next number in the dividend, which is the 3. So how many times does 156 evenly go into 473? It can evenly go in 3 times. 3 times 156 gives us 468. And we're going to subtract these two numbers. Now, when subtracting these two numbers, we obtain 5. So here, depending on your instructor, they may be happy with the quotient answer of 543 with a remainder of 5, or your instructor may want you to obtain a more accurate quotient, which just means to obtain some decimal places. So since I ran out of numbers in the dividend, what you can then do is put a decimal point right behind that last number. Now you're going to add some zeros here to the dividend, and you can add as many zeros as you like up until you get no remainder at all. So my next step is to bring this next zero down, becomes 50. 156 cannot evenly go into 50. So I'm going to put a 0 up beside this decimal point. 0 times 156 gives me 0. We subtract these two numbers and obtain 50. And we're going to bring down the next 0 in the dividend, just 500 now. So 156 can go into 500 three times evenly. 3 times 156 gives me 468. And we subtract these two numbers. And you'll notice that you can keep doing this process as many times as you like up until this remainder is zero. Or if your instructor specifically asks you for two decimal places, then you can stop now. So I'm going to stop here and say that my final answer is approximately 543.03.